Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding a welcomes hopeful afterglow written by Mehmal Sarfaraz. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2. Plus this is very important for political science, public administration, history and sociology optional students. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about the positive thing, the engagement and the talks that have begun to take place between India and Pakistan. This editorial is also about how the BJP is sustaining its meandering policy from disengagement to deeper engagement with Pakistan. Now, in order to understand this editorial, we need to compare India and China's relationship and India and Pakistan's relationship. Now, as far as India and China is concerned, we have any number of irritants. We have any number of issues. We have lot of antagonistic setups and attrition between both the nations. But what we have never witnessed between India and China is the flagration of the dispute. What we have never seen is a display of the antagonism. What we have never witnessed is a kind of an adversarial relationship. Despite fighting up a war with China in 1961, we have been engaging with China in terms of economy, in terms of social relationship, in terms of being a partner with China in its projects. We have been importing a lot of things from China. We have been exporting maybe just half of what we are importing from it to China. And in comparison to India and Pakistan, we have not been able to engage with Pakistan. We don't have a community which wants to sustain the peaceful relationship between both the nations. On the contrary, we have a business class in India and in China which wants to sustain this peace. We have the economy guiding the relationship of both the nations. The diplomacy generally takes a back seat. Now this is what is happening in the entire world. The world is not ready to fight a war because of the web that the entire world is wielded into. And this web is economic web. This economic web is not allowing the world to fight. Then there is another web, the web of globalization, that is not allowing the world to fight. Then there is another web, the web formed by the capitalists, the web formed by the multinational corporations. Now these MNCs, this globalization and the deeper engagement between the countries is not allowing them to fight with each other. But on the contrary, what we are having in India and Pakistan, there is no stake in the relationship of the nations. Now how can we create these stakeholders in the peace of India and Pakistan? Now the stakeholders can be created if we will engage economically with Pakistan. This engagement will create a business community which will put pressure on their very governments not to fight, not to enter into skirmishes, and to resolve the disputes amicably. We need to create deeper engagement in the education sector. There should be a free flow of the students across the border. Then there should be deeper engagement in terms of track 2, track 3 and track 4 diplomacy. We need to do away with just this track 1 diplomacy. This track 1 diplomacy, it has not worked. Now the stakeholders in the Pakistan for not letting the peace engender in the Indian-Pakistan's relationship are many. You have the army that don't want the peace to sustain. You have ISI that don't want the peace to sustain. Then you have China that don't want the peace to sustain between India and Pakistan. Then you have the terrorist forces, the Taliban, the Al-Qaeda, who don't want the peace to sustain. Now, these are the forces that are having a lot of stake in engendering a condition of skirmish, engendering a condition of disturbance, engendering a condition of less peace between India and Pakistan. Now we need to create counter forces, counter stakeholders, business community, education community, social community, and political community. And we also need to engage Pakistan in the various projects that the India is conceiving of, like the project of Mausam, like the project of Old Spice Route, like the project of International North-South Trade Corridor, like the pipeline project, India-Pakistan-Iran pipeline. We also need to engage Pakistan in another economic forums like SAARC. We need to make the SAARC work so that Pakistan can reap the economic benefits out of SAARC. The SAARC is lying in a state of dormancy since the days it was formed 30 years ago. We need to create, we need to catalyze, we need to strengthen, and we need to really enlighten this organization if we want to increase the stakeholders in the peace between India and Pakistan. Because it is only the stakeholders that helps in sustenance of peace. Without peace, it is very difficult. Without peace, the diplomacies of both the countries will be meandering from one end of the pendulum to the another end of the pendulum. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIS Mentors. You can contact me at 84594000 in case you're interested in buying the video class and entire Civil Services Preparation. And in order to avail the information of the classes, please visit our websites eiasmentors.com and brainyki.com. And do install our application. Name of the application is Brainyki. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. And in case you like this video, do click on the like button. Do share and comment on this video. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.